And with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com. And today we're going to talk a little bit more about putting on attachments for Invisalign or any really any kind of clear aligner company that has attachments. This is a product that kind of passed my desk, and I've heard a lot of people talk about Tetric Evo Flow. Personally, I haven't used it yet, but I'm going to start recommending people to use it. So way back when, you know, there weren't that many options for composite. You basically had the choice of packable or flowable. I've used both. A lot of it really depends on what the shape of your attachments are that are in your ClinCheck. So that's the first thing I'm going to look at. And if they're just rectangular standard attachments, it really doesn't matter what product you use. In that case, I recommend the packable and just pack it in. But if you have some of these newfangled optimized attachments with some of these really funky shapes and stuff, you're going to need a flowable. The problem with traditional flowable is that it makes a mess. And if you have flash that comes off, the aligners aren't going to seat ideally, and this is probably one of the biggest mistakes I see a lot of doctors doing, is that there's too much flash, they don't get it off, it gets messy, the aligners never quite seat properly, and because they don't seat properly, you have tracking issues, and they end up going in circles with refinements, 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 when the only issue was that they didn't do the attachments perfectly. So this EvoFlow is supposed to have best of both worlds. You have the syringe like a flowable, so you can really get in all the nooks and crannies, but it's supposed to be a little bit thicker and more gelatinous. So definitely should check it out. I don't think it's super cheap, but you could just use it only for attachments. It's supposed to also be very translucent and very easy to shape match. So check it out. And you can also check out my pigtail poking technique. Literally, you can look that up or just look up the word pig or pigtail within my YouTube channel, because this is the trick that I was trained on with flowable for Invisalign attachments, and it's always worked for me, you know. So search within my YouTube channel. To get to my YouTube channel, go to your YouTube channel in the big search bar and put in Straight Smile Solutions. That takes you to my YouTube channel. From there, there's a magnifying glass in the top right, not the corner, but top right to the right of the tabs. It's a tiny little magnifying glass. It's very subtle. Put in the word pigtail or just pig, and it'll bring a video that literally has a pigtail on it, and I'll talk about the pigtail poking technique and actually show you how to do it. I think if you use a combination of pigtail poking technique and this product, you will solve all your issues. The other recommendation I have is to go to any cannabis dispensary, or if you don't have cannabis dispensaries in your state, if you're not a Western state, and I think there's a few Eastern states that do too, you can actually buy this from Amazon. Kind of hard to find it. You got to look up like Smellproof Containers or something like that. Anyways, it's like a black smellproof container. I will see if I can find it. I may have made a video on it. I had one and some people stole it from me. I'm trying to see if I can find it. But I'm not going to say why. But in any case, the black smellproof container, you can prep your attachment templates ahead of time with, because it's not only smellproof, it's lightproof. Smellproof equals lightproof. You can fill them ahead of time, drop them in the container the night before. Obviously, you're going to do it in a super dark room. That way, your team member or the doctor can spend a little more time filling this accurately. Of course, with the flowable, you don't want to invert or anything like that. So you might want to just do one tray per thing, or maybe, I don't know, maybe you can put like a piece of wax paper or something separating the one liner from the next. Stack them, label it with the patient's name, put it on their tray, make the tray the day before. It's going to be so much easier because you can take your time filling it. I think sometimes when you're doing it chair tied, there's too much light, and you have to deliver it super fast, right? Or it's going to set. So if you fill the tray the night before, put it in that smell-proof container, they're about 15 bucks for one of those containers. You could definitely fit. They come in all different sizes. They usually round, but they're always black. So stack them, put them on the tray the night before, leave it there. Next morning, it's ready to go. All you have to do is go ahead and throw your cotton rolls in the patient's mouth. I really love the Nola suction device. It helps really, really well. Don't do both trays at one time, just do one. And if you really feel like you're slow, you can always cut it in half. But if you already pre-filled it, there should be no reason to. Look at the ClinCheck and see exactly where the attachments are. Only put the etch exactly where the attachments are. Do not etch the whole tooth. Now you're going to have trouble getting the flash off, right? Put the little bead of etch just where the attachments are. Follow the ClinCheck as a guide. Rinse, dry till chalky. Then go ahead and prime. The prime isn't a big deal. Don't use the etch and prime in one, the elbows, lollipops. They're super technique sensitive, and you have more failure unless you're doing it exactly right. you know, scrub your prime in. Some of them you have to light thin, some of you have to light cure. Read the directions, and then you can go ahead and just slap that tray on. It's already been pre-filled. Light cure, peel it off. There should be very little flash that comes out if you filled it correctly. But the flash should be able to come off with a scaler, if there is it, assuming you etched only the right spots. And then it should be really easy. And the other cool trick you can use is you can use a black light. You can buy a black light. I bought one from $7 from Amazon. I still have it. It's really useful to look for like animal pee. And like if you clean the bathrooms and you go and turn the light off and you shine it, you can find teenage boy pee all over the place. I use it for cleaning my bathrooms. But really great for shining in the patient's mouth and looking for flash from composite too. You know, you want the attachments to literally look like just like they do on the Clincheck. And if you see any flash that you miss, because this stuff is super clear, just scoop it off, you know? And then you can go ahead and go. And this, I mean, your attachments should not fall off if you do this. Only time attachments would fall off in this case is if you had a really weird shape and the patient ate like nuts or something like that. If the attachments are falling off within a day or two, that's on you. That was a bonding error on your part. You're not isolating correctly. If it's lower molar attachments that are falling off, it could be the patient's occlusion. They could be biting on it. In that case, you might want to add some anterior bite turbos to the case, do a warranty fit, or have a patient eat with the aligners in. I know that sounds a little tricky, but the cool thing about eating with your aligners in and like only taking them out to brush, that means you're wearing them 3.75 hours per day, 24 hours a day, is that it's actually accelerated ortho treatment and you can change trays way faster, like every 3 to 4 days. It's a super cool hack. Instead of paying for one of these B-Pro 5 units or one of these like hyper bite units or something like that, why? This is free. It's free. So, and you can actually speed up treatment or you could slow down treatment and it's just gonna crazy track. But in any case, that's all my tips for you for Invisalign attachments. Hopefully that was helpful. Thank you.